Hi, as I promised you in my bun parota video, today I am here with the recipe for salna. You can eat this not only along with parota, you can also serve this as a side dish for pulao, biryani, chapati, idli, dosa or rice as well. Today I am going to show you the one they prepare in Tamil Nadu restaurants, which they used to serve with parota or biryani. Just make sure to have the correct measurement of spices, you'll surely need it. Let's see how to make this spicy and yummy plain salna. These are the ingredients for grinding. Here I have 20 shallots or small onion, 2 garlic pods finely chopped, a small piece of ginger finely chopped, and 1/4 cup of grated coconut. If you have fresh, you can use it. 8 to 10 cashew nuts, 3 to 4 mint leaves, and few coriander leaves, 4 green chilies, you can add or reduce according to your spice level, a small piece of cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of fennel seeds, 2 cloves, 1 small petal of nutmeg flower, 1 green cardamom and some kalpasi or blackstone flower. So these are the ingredients to fry and then grind. And 1 tablespoon of coconut oil, use only coconut oil for this recipe. In a kadai, add coconut oil and let it become hot. When it's hot enough, add all the dry spices. Fry this until you get a nice aroma, until a minute or so. Into this, add the cashew nuts and fry until it gets golden brown in color. Now add the chopped ginger and garlic and fry for a few seconds. Add the shallots. If you don't have shallots, you can also add 2 medium-sized big onions. When the onions are still cooking, add green chilies. Fry this for 5 to 7 minutes until the onions are properly cooked. After 7 minutes, add the coconut. Mix this well and add coriander and mint leaves. Fry this in a medium heat until the coconut starts getting golden brown in color. Now turn off the heat, let this cool down and then we'll grind this into a smooth paste adding some water. Let's see the other ingredients. 2 medium sized onions sliced and 1 big tomato chopped. These are the spice powders. 1 tablespoon coriander powder, 1/2 tablespoon chili powder, 1/4 teaspoon turmeric powder and 1/4 teaspoon garam masala powder. For tempering, 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds, few curry leaves. I have taken frozen, but if you have fresh, you can take fresh curry leaves and 2 red chilies. Some salt to taste, 2 tablespoons of coconut oil and the freshly prepared coconut masala paste. Heat oil in a kadai. When it's hot enough, add all the tempering ingredients and fry this for just 10 seconds. Now add the onions and fry this until onion is cooked well and transparent. It is very important to make sure that the onions are cooked really well. This might take about 5 to 7 minutes. So keep mixing until then and never allow this to burn. Add some salt to taste. Mix this well. Now add the tomatoes and cook this approximately for 3 minutes until they are mushy. When they are still cooking, add all the spice powders. They are cooked. Now let's add the coconut masala paste. Mix this really well until the coconut paste is nicely combined with onion, tomato and all the spices. To this, add 2 cups of water. Cover the lid and let this cook for about 20 minutes in a low heat. Check the salt and if you feel it's less, add accordingly. Finally, add few chopped coriander leaves and turn off the heat. It's ready to be served now. I hope you'll try this at home. If you like my video, please don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe to my channel. So see you in another interesting video. Until then, bye.